Hey everybody, it's MakeupMenaree. Welcome back to my channel. So I have been sort of wanting to do this kind of video for a long time, but I feel like maybe some people will take it the wrong way because, you know, I'm not a huge channel. I don't have a huge amount of followers, but there are some tips that a lot of, I think, smaller YouTubers are not really aware of. A lot of free information and items that people can use for their channels to help grow their channel. I was watching a fellow smaller YouTube channel, Jazz Up My Style. She went ahead and did a video on this type of subject, you know, stuff that she sort of wished she knew before she had a YouTube channel or while she was growing her channel. I will link her channel in the description box below. She has amazing content. She does a lot of TJ Maxx hauls. She lives in New York, so they have amazing, like, items in the store. I'm so jealous of the stores that they have there. But there are some things that she didn't touch on in her video that I sort of wanted to touch on in this video. It's more of a technical type situation, sort of behind the scenes on how to help grow your channel. So this channel is only about 6 months old, very, very close to reaching the amount of time to where I can monetize my channel. So thank you Jesus for that, because that's going to be so exciting to be able to create more content for you guys, because my channel will just have, I'll just have more options when I'm able to monetize. And of course, I'll be getting a little bit of money, so that's nice too. I can go ahead and reinvest back in my channel. Maybe get your girl some lights or a camera. You have to have 4,000 hours of watch time to be able to monetize your channel. Like I said, I'm probably a few videos away from that, so I'm so excited about that. But a lot of people don't really understand how YouTube works, especially if you're wanting to do this. I hate to say as a business, because I don't think you should get into YouTube if you want to do it as a business. There's a lot of people that do that, and that's fine for them. But for me, it's never really been about that. It's been about just being able to get on camera and play with makeup and have an excuse to play with makeup, shut that damn bedroom door, and my family leaves me the hell alone because they know I'm here recording. And just being able to teach everybody the skills that I know and share my information with you guys. So I wanted to share with you guys some things that a lot of smaller YouTubers I don't think really know in regards to the back end of making videos. And I have been super lucky to have my best friend is a huge, he's got a huge channel. I'm sure y'all already know Linwood and Allison at Glamfam. And a lot of the times he and I have learned some things together. He's very, very involved in his channel. He's very market oriented. He loves to grow his channel and find new ways and things to help his channel grow. So he always shares things with me, and I'm so, so lucky to have him as a mentor here on YouTube. Okay, so the first thing that I suggest you do if you have started a channel is to download TubeBuddy. I will link everything that I know in the description box below, so you guys can go back and, you know, check out the things that I'm linking. A free app, and you can download it on your cell phone, any of your mobile devices. This app allows you to view all your comments on your videos, which is amazing because I use that all the time because I record on my cell phone. I am able to go on the and scroll through all my comments, reply, delete comments, interact with you guys on a regular basis. And it also shows you all your analytics of your videos. It shows you how many views you have, how much watch time you have on that video. It has an amazing range of information for you to use that will help you grow your channel. I suggest you do if you have started a channel is to download TubeBuddy. Download that onto your computer or onto your actual device that you are editing your videos, like I have it on my laptop. When you are going to tag videos, and I'll get into tagging in a minute too, because that's super important that I feel like a lot of smaller channels don't do or don't know about. It will show you the rankings of all tags on other people's videos. So I can go to a big channel's videos, click over, and because I have that TubeBuddy app downloaded, it will tell me like the rankings of their tags, like if they tagged eyebrows, what ranking it is. And you can go through and steal or borrow those tags and tag them on your own video. And then when you are finished, it will you know, order, put them, sort them in order, rankings. So from the bottom, the top ranking to the bottom ranking, it suggests tags for you. It is an amazing app to have to help tag videos. I use it tagging my videos, and I feel like that helps a lot with my views. So yeah, TubeBuddy, download it, start playing with it. Use it for your channel. It's an amazing free app to have. TubeBuddy, I feel like that's the first thing you should do when you start, you know, uploading videos on your own channel, is to get that app and start using it. Okay, since we're talking about tagging, I will go ahead and just talk about that briefly. So tagging is the way that people are going to be able to find your videos. Without tags, that doesn't link your videos to searches. So if somebody is searching eyebrows, and you have a video that's about eyebrows, you want to tag eyebrows in your video. You also want to make sure that when you are using your tags down below, a certain amount of tags you can use, use as many tags as you can. I usually do all the 100 or however many, or 500, I think it's 500. I max it out. And then those top tags, you want to go ahead and put that in your description somewhere in your video up, you know, when you're talking about what your video is about. So if you tag eyebrows below, in the tagging section, you want to make sure that you say eyebrows up in the description box as well. The way people find your videos is by these tagging these words, these keywords. And yeah, so like I said, with TubeBuddy, that helps a lot with that. Another huge thing that I feel is very beneficial for channels that are starting out is make sure you interact with your subscribers. It's fun interacting. You guys are on my channel. I know sometimes I have more comments than I do views on my videos, and I don't really mind that. It helps my channel because it's just hilarious. You know, we are hella inappropriate over here on this channel. We say all kinds of crazy things, especially in the comments. And I love interacting with you guys. And I feel like a lot of you guys are like personal friends by this point. That helps me as well. It's called engagement. So any engagement on your channel, whether it be you creating playlists or uploading new content or commenting back and forth with your subscribers, helps your channel grow. It also YouTube looks at it as you are, you know, engaging, you're active on your channel, and that will help your channel be promoted, you know, in the recommendation column, or, you know, YouTube pushing your video for other people to see. It helps on your videos. So commenting back and forth with your subscribers, being very interactive with them, is not only helping you to have an amazing relationship with your subscribers, but it helps with your engagement, and engagement helps your channel grow. So make sure to keep that in mind. I see some channels that don't really talk back and forth with their subscribers, and for one, that's sort of like dookie, because your subscribers are the ones that are helping your channel grow in the first place, so you should at least interact with them. But for two, it doesn't help with their engagement. So you'll look and they have 20,000 subscribers, but on their videos, they only have a couple hundred views. And I feel like, you know, you're not building a relationship with your subscribers, so they're not going to come back and watch, and they're not going to comment because they know that you don't comment back. And that's hurting you in several ways. It's hurting your engagement on your channel. It's hurting you with subscribers. So always engage with your subscribers, comment back and forth. It helps your channel grow. Also, in regards to engagement and helping you grab maybe some more subscribers or people coming over to your channel, is I always like to go on, this is sort of like scamming. Well, it's not even a scam. It's like, you know, I go on big YouTube channels that I love watching, and I don't do this on random channels, just people that I like. If I happen to be able to get on a channel where I got an alert and it's super early in the game, and I comment, I always make sure to sort of comment something to let people know that I also have a channel. So if it's a big channel and they're doing a makeup look, I will always say, oh, you know, I would love to try this look on my channel, or something like that, you know, complimenting them, but also letting their subscribers know, or whoever sees that comment, know that I also have a channel. So I have gotten countless subscribers that way, and it's part of engagement. It's part of letting people sort of, you know, advertising on other people's videos. I'm not rude or ugly about it. I always compliment, you know, the video that I'm watching. Just, you know, slide a comment in there about you having a channel as well, and you'll see people will come over and they'll be like, oh, I saw your comment on so-and-so's channel, and here I am. Selfless plug. So another way, like I said, interacting is supporting smaller channels like yourself. Befriend those channels. They're your friends, you know, we're all in this together. There's plenty of views for everybody. And you can get a lot of good ideas and bounce each other, you know, ideas off each other. I always feel like, you know, engaging, you know, following them, watching their videos, commenting, letting them know you're there for support is an amazing way to build a friendship or a relationship with another channel. And you guys can share information back and forth. And, you know, that's good for everybody. So I definitely feel like make sure to support other channels that are about the same size or smaller than yourself. You know, there's no reason why you shouldn't. A few other little sort of, not really behind the scenes, but things that I feel like smaller channels don't really or aren't really understanding or sort of, it's difficult to figure out unless you have somebody helping you, is making sure your titles are really good on your videos, because that's the way people find your videos when they search in, you know, the search engine, what they're looking for. Your title is what pulls your video up. So if you have a video about, you know, lipstick, but your title was like, you know, how I found, you know, my perfect shade of lips, that sort of doesn't correspond with lipstick. So you should have lipstick sort of in the beginning of the title somewhere. So you can even, like, when I'm doing titles, sometimes I go into my Yoda talk, like how he would talk sort of backwards, like lipstick the shade is, or lipstick my favorite color is. That kind of thing has always helped me with my titles. You want to make sure that that keyword is in the beginning of the title, so when they search that title or that information that they're looking for, your video will pop up. So just be mindful that your title is basically one of the first things that people see and that they're searching for, and that's the way that people find your video. So make sure your titles correspond with what you're wanting people to, you know, find or what's in your videos. Okay, and I know this video is hella long, but the last thing that I think is super important in regards to having a channel and having it be more successful is your watch time and view time. So I feel like people are not super familiar or they don't know what that means. So watch time and view time is basically how many minutes people have watched your videos. And it's a compilation of all your videos together. So you have a certain amount of minutes. Like I said, if you're wanting to monetize your videos and start making money off your video and become a YouTube partner, you have to have at least 4,000 hours, which is 240,000 minutes, I believe, of watch time. Videos when you first start out should be about 5 minutes or so. Once your channel grows a little bit more and you have more people that are coming to your videos, I would probably shoot for 10 minutes or so. Anything longer than that, you risk, like this video being hella long, you risk people sort of like logging off and not watching your entire video. But it just depends, like, on the video. If it's a get ready with me or a story time, that kind of video, those can be longer and engage, you know, as long as you're engaging and funny and it's interesting, you know, people will watch. View time is really important. I know people focus a lot on subscribers, and of course, having a lot of subscribers will bring a lot of view time, but there's channels that don't have a ton of subscribers, but their videos are 20, 30,000 views. That's, if you're interested in monetizing, is where you're going to, that's the important area, the view time. The view time is what's going to get you, you know, monetized quicker. It's going to make you money on your videos. Subscribers are amazing and I love you guys all, but you don't have to have a million subscribers to make money on YouTube. It's all about people watching your videos.
Okay, so while I was editing this video, I forgot to mention about pinning your comments to the top of the comment section. I always like to pin all my comments. It usually has like the products that I use or the description of the video. Is what I'll do is just copy and paste that, put it in the comments, and then you click over and there is a pin option. You just pin it, and then I always like my own comment and love my own comment, and people are more likely to like reply to those comments and see what you used or read your description if you want to put it there. You can basically put any kind of note you want, but make sure to pin it to the top. That way everybody sees your comment first before they scroll down and start looking at other people's comments.
I hope you guys like this video. I'm sorry it's a little rambly, but there's a lot of information that I feel when I'm watching channels, I feel like they don't want to share behind the scenes stuff. And it's free information, but it's just hard to get that information. I feel a lot of bigger channels don't, they sort of slide over, you know, how they're doing that. Maybe they don't know how because they have all these teams that work for them. But for us grunts, for us smaller channels, you know, we sort of have to figure it out ourselves. So yeah, that is a list of things. I will make sure to drop them in the description box below. If you guys have any other information that I might not have talked about, please make sure to comment below. I love sharing information like this in regards to smaller channels because I feel like nobody's really looking out for us but ourselves. And I learned that the hard way when my old channel was deleted and I had absolutely no help from this platform and things we had to sort of figure out ourselves. So we really don't have anybody looking out for us but ourselves. So make sure to be mindful of that. Share your information with other smaller channels. Have any questions about any of the information that I dropped? Comment below. I would love to share information with you guys. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys next time.